Tone HD,
me Red.
You know, we in here together, man. I want to give him a little bit of history with me and you, man. You know, me and E played ball together. We lost that state championship together. Y'all lost one too after we left.
Yeah.
You know, Shelby down here. You know, we known for hooping. Coach P's in what, coach? 900 game plus one.
The number.
Last time I talked to him, he was passed
900.
So, you know, we peak boys. You know, everybody ain't get to be one of peak boys. You know, and we want to, we two of peak boys.
Hey,
you know, a lot of people don't recognize how much of a privilege it is to be one of peak boys. Coach put a lot of discipline in us, man, and, you know, we learned a lot. He moved us around, showed us some different things, treated us pretty good. You know, but like I say, me and E go back from before this time, but one of the most significant times in me and his friendship and our dealing was, you know, he was 10th grade, I was 12th grade. We was on the basketball team together. Walsh, you had come down here with that Five New Pie stuff and put us on that noob stuff, man. We had that Capital League going. Some of y'all probably remember that, man. We was fly. I don't know what y'all thought, but yeah, we was what that was. And you know, but like I said, I just want to throw that out there. So, man, me and E go back to that point, man. That was, we looking at 16, that was 16 years ago. So that was 99. Here we are, 2015, and, we didn't have a lot of conversations, man. You know, we decided that we gotta put out a lot of positive energy, man, and make the people's perception messed up in a lot of places about what's really happening around here. You know, so what you gotta say to him, Pete?
Man, like you said about Pete, you know, I laughed because I was thinking earlier, like, you know, we used to be at the park. People used to, they didn't play ball, and the people used to be like, well, peak boys. That was the name. You played on them. So that alone.
That's like a secret society around here.
Like I said, that was a loan right there. That's a whole nother group of individuals within one town, but it was still all, you know, still all love, because that's the influences that he had on everyone's life. Because, you know, if you was one of peak boys, that you did stuff a certain way. So, right. and in that instance, we kind of not missing, it ain't completely gone, but that was a big influence that we have to get back to, being that influence over younger people's lives.
Right,
so,
right.
Because when you was a peak boy, you get in trouble.
He was a father figure.
You get in trouble, in school, out of school,
right.
You was in trouble with Pete. I don't know if you might have feared Pete more than the police. You did.
That's why I said we need more men that the children is scared of. Not like, you know,
scared of them, but respect.
That level of respect for, yeah. You know, to where they watch what the children watch what they say around you. You know, they watch what they do away from you, because that's how much of an impact you got on them like that. You know, so
a positive impact.
Right, you own it, man. We need that.
So that's like a big thing, man. So all the way back from then, you know, I've been knowing Pete. We live around the corner, Rummers,
right.
From Pete. So Pete had a positive impact on so many kids' lives. Even if you didn't play ball for him, like,
let me throw something in there. I don't cut you. I'm gonna throw this in there. I was gonna say it before you guys started this time, but Coach Peason pulled me to the side one time, man. It was my senior year. It was time for you know, all of the voting and all that for student body president and all that. And Coach Peason pulled me to the side and he said, "Tony Harry," he said, "now you know ain't nobody, don't nobody need to be no student body president but you." He said, "So quit playing and go take care of your business." And that's what made me go and get that, you know, that student body president position that I had that year, because he told me, so I'm bearing witness to that positive, that positive influence from Coach Peterson.
Yeah, man, it's people like that that's in our lives, man, that's still in our lives today. Thank God for that.
Right.
That, you know, we cherish. We don't always see it or always acknowledge them. You know, when we see them and tell them how much we appreciate stuff like that. So even with this, shout out, Coach, man. Like, you're
salute, man.
You're a big impact on our lives.
I tell you, when I see you, we talk about it, man. Tone HD, man. E Red, we here. What's up, man? What you want to say to him, man?
Chilling out here. You know
what you want to say to him, V.I.?
Straight for the fucking sip, always turned up, nigga.
Always. Smoketown, USA. We do it big down here. Sorry about that.
Sorry, bro. My boy, man, it's Peter. DJ Cargo, man.
Oh, let Cargo do that himself. Yeah, hold on, man. Go the long route with it. Introduction, man.
Coming up, holes in my socks.
short pants, striped shirts, all that old 80s stuff, man. I'm a 79.
Yeah.
Boom. 80s baby, man. I don't take nothing away from that. But I grew up right here in the smoke, man. It just, I was Petey all my life. Just Petey.
30.
Got another nickname by a baller.
They don't know about 30.
Big 30.
Yeah.
But man, you know, life goes on and you know, people make changes. You know, Beyonce got Sasha Fierce and all that old type of stuff. And Jay-Z is Hov. And man, you know, it's somewhere in between that, man, I started entertaining. And Petey became DJ Cargo.
DJ Cargo.
So that's who I am. Hey, everybody
talk to me about that. Slow down. I mean, I ain't cutting you off. Don't want you to switch the subject. I want you to slow it up. I want to understand that. I want them to understand that block party thing better, man.
Well, I found out, you know, everybody been kind of debating about this block party, about how long it's been going on, you know. And I find out how long it's been going on just by somebody giving me some information that was funny to me. I met this girl. We ain't go together or nothing, but I met her for the first time at the block party. She said it was 15 years ago this weekend.
Hmm.
That means the block party been going on
since
16, yeah, okay.
Right.
16 years, because we had the first block party, and then I met her on the second block party. And if she said it was 15 years, which she's correct.
Right, numbers don't lie.
Numbers don't lie. That means this year makes 16.
Okay.
16 years of block party. And man, real life, the block party started off as a water fight. The block
man,
party.
I don't remember
that.
Nobody remembers.
Listen to me.
The block party started off as a water fight.
I don't remember that.
Remember Dirty Truck had the gray truck?
Yes.
Yeah, I remember that.
The gray truck.
I remember that.
We used to ride around Chevy on the back of the gray truck.
Yeah.
And there used to be, that block right there always been hot, period. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So there used to be just the meet up point. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't even originally a block party. But it was just where everybody was. So Memorial Weekend, water fight. Around the end of school, water fight, kind of the same thing, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I forgot about.
Yeah, because we 16 years ago, you was a 20-year-old, I was an 18-year-old, you was a 16-year-old. See what I'm saying?
Yep.
So that sound about right.
And man, I mean, we just sit there, man, and just had that water fight all day long. It was just straight love all day, man. Then everybody on back of Chuck truck, they come through with the Kansas Bill Holler State champ. What's happening? How you doing? They come through and they run, they holler state champ, shaking up beers. And nobody drinking the beers now.
Yeah.
But they just opened the beers and just fall over everywhere. Yeah. Everybody went crazy, man. And from that year on, man, the block party been an annual event. That night, we ain't had no music. We just had each other.
Right.
Exactly. And after that, then the following year, that's my, don't worry, that's my text.
All right. So you're going to learn today. They are going to learn today.
So it started the next year. We rented some speakers and just put them outside the house, and it just got bigger and bigger. And Lord have mercy, when Cargo came on the scene, when it went from Peter to DJ Cargo,
right?
You had a legitimate live DJ who was doing it for the community absolutely free, man.
Right.
I don't want nothing. I don't need nothing out of this. All I need is for everybody to have a safe time.
See, man. I ain't know
we've
that,
been
man.
Doing even, this all the time.
Even, right. even when it died down, you know, like Memorial Weekend had almost died off. Like it had, it got weak, like beyond nobody coming home, nothing. That's when they start skipping it to every other year. Then they try to start it back. So Mad Dan called, he got in touch with Alexis and the twins, and right around the same time I had moved back to the crib. So he was talking, he was just like, you know, we wanna try to, you know, bring that back how it used to be. So last year class 01, we kind of put everything together for the weekend, made it a Mardi Gras theme and stuff like that and things like that. So just kind of generate that. Then coming back fast forward to this year, you know, Peter called me. He was like, man, what we going to do? You know, I'm in Texas now. So what we going to, man, just tell me whatever we going to do, and I'm with it. So, you know, class got all that. They got all that together. I'm down in the burg now, but they got all that together and same thing. So just, when I created
that
group on Facebook
about 2 weeks ago.
That jump was on fire.
Yeah, about 2 weeks ago, man.
Smoketown Memorial Weekend,
beef group. You know, we just talking about old times, remember this, remember that. So it was just a thing to where, you know what I'm saying, we put that's positive energy, man. It bring everybody home. Like, we talking about going home. Once you hear one person talk about it, they be like, yeah, let me see about going to the crib. So, you know what I'm saying? And even with the block party, I get on there, you know, give my little voice, my little I ain't gonna say DJ voice. Yeah. You know, my MC voice and things like that.
I know what you're talking about.
Tell them, you know, get home, man.
You know what's amazing amazing that you can have a group like that, and people don't understand how the closeness of what we do in Shelby. Right. It's amazing that you can get a group like that, and you can have over 70 to 120, 180 people inside a group and talking noise about their class and talking noise about somebody's right. class, and it's never a dull moment, and there's never any attitude, no cussing you out type stuff, no one right. to fight you. I mean, this is
grown. Nah, this ain't real. Stuff, it ain't right? real beef.
It ain't real beef. It's love.
It's because
you got 92 talking about 97, and right. you see each other, the very first thing you do is hug, and then you talk about it, then you talk about
and you can't tell nobody that they class ain't that fire.
And I'm going to talk about everybody. Everybody that I talk crazy to for weeks, first thing they do, come here, crazy boy, because I hadn't seen them. It's right. all love, man. Ain't nobody said nothing in the group probably since. We've been posting pictures talking about how this look, how that look. But, man, it's because it's all about the smoke, man. Like we said earlier, Cargo wasn't with us. You know, Smoketown ain't about the trees and whatever else you plan on smoking if you indulge in all that. But
right.
Smoketown, this Smoketown.
Right.
HD Smoketown.
Right.
What I'm standing on is Smoketown.
Right.
Man, the people of Shelby, man, that's Smoketown.
Smoketown, USA. Hey. Hey, what's up?
So,
you got a shout out, man. Holler at him, man.
Oh, you already know 9-9. Fine. The vine, yeah. like wine, yeah. all the time. Yeah. On your mind, spit a rhyme like
yeah.
a dime.
Yeah.
Man, I don't even know where to go with this time.
What's up, man?
Shut up, slugger, baby. About to get this thing kicked off this season, baby.
Oh,
one
really?
For 7 in a row, baby. 7 slugger, baby.
7 Pete.
7 time champ, baby.
Oh, really?
You hear what I say now?
Let's go!
What's up with it, 9-8? What's up with it, 9-8? What's up, Skeeter Matt?
What's up, bro? What's up, Rip? What up, bro?
To go out, you know, that live in places way bigger than Shelby. You know, there are a lot of people that are more rich. Are one of the DJs right there,
Doc Woods,
legendary DJ. You know, people, especially that homecoming weekend, man, when it's for real, man. People, man, you gonna see people from Chicago up here. People gonna come out. Ain't no telling, because you got people that leave ship and go somewhere else and be successful enough to get home, bring people back with them, man. And like I said, the block party is really your best opportunity to see that real crowd, you know, that we draw in. You know, the club scene is, you really can't, because people gonna be spread out outside all over the place, and then people might be packed up inside. But the block party, that's why one of my men say something about it, you know, because a lot of people, you know, seen that back down in the Mississippi video, and you know, the DJ Cargo show was a part of that.
Sitting up there, you know, just acting foolish. That's what we do. So, and it's just, you know, all these years, sit back and we go back all years when I first started DJing, and this makes year like year number 7 or 8 that I've done it. And since I first started that, and people's like, well, I don't want to go, it might be too much fighting. Come on, man. Come on, like for real, all jokes aside, 8 years, we had one altercation that was way down the street. It was not at the block party.
Talk
it
about
was
that.
Way down the street.
Right. Do them numbers. 8 years, one fight. Numbers don't lie, man.
And so if you ask me, it wasn't at the block party.
Right, right.
So it happened down the street. The police felt threatened, and they said, you know what, let's go ahead and shut it down. And mind you, it was shut down 20 minutes early. So come on, man. You can't. It's crime everywhere.
You can't give us our other 20 minutes, dog. Yeah, for real, man.
You know.
But with our homecoming weekend, man, you won't get to see. If you see Shelby without it being homecoming weekend, you really don't have what you need to really judge and see what Shelby is, man. You can't let the ghost town, you know, Smoketown, daytime ghost town. You can't let that ghost town fool, that ghost town part of it fool you, man.
Nighttime,
they be in the house.
Go down,
man. They be in the house. But like I said, you have to see Shelby, man, when it's homecoming. That means when people that grew up here, when we come home. Man. A lot of people out there in Texas have their home. And it's cool. But say, man, they can't.
There's no place like home.
No place. They can't get.
No place like
home. I get chills. Get on.
Can't get with that, man. For real.
HD Cargo. Be ready, man. It's understood. Sanity, that's right. Look, y'all, we got left.
How do the people step on?
Like friends and family. Heaven, happiness, health, and sanity. So place nothing above your force, not your love relatives, but the ones who love you most. Let's go. Come on, y'all, let's have a jamboree or a family reunion.
Me right there, man. 85-804-HERN, man. 85-18.
Turn the music up and dance with me like you got ants in your pants.
That was me right there, man. That's why I grew up. That's my street. Shout out to Jeff Cahey, man. Buck Rogers.
Kids in the street. Some of them might get out, some of them might not. So, some people say they don't even stop, so they get hit that song.
See, that ain't even moving.
Difference.
Yeah, somebody grandmama, somebody auntie, some adult. Right outside. At the street, somebody was watching somebody at all times.
We had that conversation with
my classmates yesterday, man.
What's up, man? You all right?
Yeah, I'm chilling.
You all right? What's your name? Talk to him, man. Tell everybody your name, how old you are, man.
Right there, I'm 14.
Already, man. What you going to do when you grow up?
Be a football player.
Already. And if that don't work, what you going to do?
I'm just going to, you know, find a job, make some money.
That's the thing right there. It ain't just find a job, make some money.
Because it's going to be some chump change. Oh,
even what you saying, you going to football. You work everything you got into your first plan. Your second plan can be a part of your first plan. So what if it ain't football? What if it's coaching? Or what if it's specific to whatever position you play? What if it's sports training or something like that? So whatever it is, if that's what you, your main thing, you lock into that. But make sure you got something. If that's what you love, make sure the next thing you fall back on is in that same area too, so you can still be doing something you love, you know what I'm saying? So always look at that, then look at the next route, the next two routes. It's always another step, promise. Always got to be another step. Once that don't work out, you know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing in stone.
What happened, man?
I got crossed up a couple times.
You got crossed up. Let me see that, man. Look, and this is what I want to do. What I want to do, I want to start coming back, going like basketball camp and stuff, y'all.
This for my hoopers, you know what I'm saying?
We talking to the whole world. What's your name, man?
Man, what's your real name? How old are you? All right.
My name is traffic. And I'm 10,
You
might be famous one day. I'm very telling people. I'm ready to show them this video. Yeah.
14. 8th grade going tonight.
College. I'm 14. And I'm going to the 9th grade.
I'm Saeed. I'm 11. And I'm going to the 6th grade. I'm
Zakiya,
I'm 13,
I'm
going to the
next grade. I'm Damian, I'm 13, I'm going to the next grade. I'm making that video still.
Well, I'm Tony Harris. She's shy. I ain't. She's shy and I'm not. I'm Tony Harris. I'm 34. And I'm going summer everywhere, man. I want to take a whole lot of y'all with me. So tell me what y'all tell all in what we want before you turn it off.
Shit.
What they call Shelby?
Smoketown.
What they call Shelby?
Smoketown.
What they call Shelby?
Smoketown.
Y'all don't smoke with me.
No.
Alright, I was just making sure. Oh, hey. Speak up, man, and pump your chest with them. Let them know you mean that.
My name is Zion, and I'm 7.
What grade you in?
I'm in first grade.
And I'm going to keep it real all my life. That's what he's telling y'all.
Don't wait till you graduate, man. Don't put out what you want. You figure out two or three things you might want to do. Learn about the children where it's at, man. You know,
you see how we walked up to them and just... They cooperative, man. They influence. We couldn't walk up on no like that and done that, man. So we got to, you know, say, get you knucklehead grown up. Not the people that ain't knuckleheads, but the knucklehead. I'll let y'all get on out the way somewhere, man. But these children, man, like I say, if we got to go through youth sports to teach them some order and some structure, through the sports it is. But like I say, man, we got to teach them, man. They influence you. You can tell them something. You see how easy they come over here and they happy with it, too, man. They glad they getting that kind of attention from us, too, man. Like I said, man, Tone HD, man, we in it for good. If you don't want to try, then get out the way. I like to have fun. All right, y'all ready?
Yes.
Whoever can do this right here.
Let him back up.
Okay. Do it right again. You might come close enough. One more time. Get somebody else if you don't get it.
I did.
Put on that arm first.
Oh, snap.
All right, let somebody else try. Now, practice that though on your own time, all right? Try again. Who else gonna try? Before she get it wet.
Try
with that one.
I'm gonna try.
Look. All right, who got handles then?
Me. Oh, me. Yeah, that's it.
Me.
All right, let's go over here to the tripod then. See who got him. Bring that other ball then. Who got the handle? Who got the ball? All right, we'll get up to the first ball first. You got him? All right, do what I do. Line up beside me. Line up beside me, face that way. You line up beside me. All right, we're going to cross over side to side. Third person mess up, got to get the ball somebody else. Let's go. Side to side, let's go. Can't look at it. Can't look at it. All right, if y'all last 5 more seconds, we're going to something else. 5, 4, 3, 2. All right, do what I do. Let's go. Do what I do. Whoever messes up first, they got to give it up. He said, oh, snap. All right, get a ball up. Oh, I got to give it up. Let's go. Somebody get it.
Zion, come on.
All right, give it up. Give it up. He's still going. Give it up. Oh, give it up. You messed up. Let me get yours. You gotta open your feet up. All right, let's go to something else. Same two people. Let's go to something else. All right. Watch this. Hold on.
Oh, bro.
man.
Because every time I come, man, I come check on the kids at the park, and y'all sure be out here. We'll be out here. I'm going to be out here tomorrow, too.
I ain't going to be here tomorrow.
Where you going?
You messed up.
Right.
Messed up.
But your parents from here?
No.
Okay. See, we got people all the way down here who come from Chicago to check out the smoke, man. But we're going to holler at y'all. I just had to come check y'all out up close, man.
Sean, somebody, he on the trailer. Matter of fact, I need babysitting fees. I need you to pay me $20 for the last 20 minutes. I've been watching him. He up trying to set the trailer on fire.
I got a lot going on, baby. What you got?
It's your boy DJ Clive on your boy. You're in Smoketown. Homecoming 2015. Smoketown, make some noise.
Yeah.
We got class of 2000. Class of 2001. Class of 97. Class of 2003, 2004, 95, 96, 94. I would say 2002, but I ain't never done nothing. They are. It's your boy, E-Man, DJ Cargo, let's go.
I just wanted to get right here, and because when I'm coming in, like, a lot of people come in on that backside. Then they come up right here, but I like to come in right here so I can see this, man. Seeing this, I posted on Facebook that a sign, always coming for the real thing. I'm talking about me. I'm probably speaking for a lot of y'all too, because, you know, because a lot of us, we moved away, man. We come back home. When I come here and I see this, it get real serious. And it's just like seeing that the water tower, man. It's like a reality star setting. I'm about to get to see, man, these people that I love, that I know love me, man. I know it. I know it for a fact. You know, that's why I'm putting it out there like that. You know, so I just wanted to come up here, man, look at the sign, man, that you will see before the real thing, man. The real thing is over in here, man. And you really can't see the real thing. Man, you catch the people when they come home. Shelby cool, but homecoming, man, when people actually come home, it's unreal, man. It's unreal.
Yeah, man, like Tom was talking about, the respect, man, the positive side of Shelby, Mississippi, like, a lot of great people come from Shelby. A lot of great people have people that live in Shelby that come visit Shelby. So it's more so about what we got to do to counter some of the stuff that we're going through and stuff we see continuously go through.
Right.
That's a cycle.
Got to break
BS,
that.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's just like people say you got to break that cycle. You got to break that chain. People contribute there. They talk about that. They talking about like the kids and stuff like that out of wedlock. You got to break that cycle, but forget that. It's much bigger than that. Why are we talking about something small? Like it's way bigger than that, man. It starts all the way from what you're learning, what you eat.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Who you with? You know the energy that you put out. You got to get it comes back.
Reap what you sow.
And reap what you sow.
Get out of what you put in.
Even with reaping what we sow, like right now. We want positive things to come out of this. We want people to see the positive side of Shelby, right?
Right.
You know, RIP Lil Tony, man. Friday, you know, some BS, man, but that's not all what Shelby about.
Right.
It ain't about just coming here, kicking it for the weekend and stuff like that. We gotta start doing more for Shelby. A lot of money is outside of Shelby right now. People making money. We gotta come, when we come back stuff like this, we spend our money in Shelby. We come to Shelby for Memorial Weekend, we really leave Shelby.
Right.
But we trying to keep that money in Shelby. You know, with people, the vendors that come in, my boy Tone, a t-shirt, stuff like that. You know, people, we got to start getting more people to come home and spend that money inside our own community.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So spend that money with each other. Let that money flip between us. So, you know, the positive side of Shelby, man, like I said, respect. Always had, wasn't much to do in this small town, but sports, respect. People that's in your neighborhood, stuff like that. It's just I can go next door, I ain't worried about nothing to eat. You know what I'm saying? That's what we were now, you know, and we've gotten away from that. Like, we don't really deal with our neighbors. I don't even know if everybody you really like your neighbors and stuff like that. We ain't have that kind of stuff.
Divide and conquer.
Yeah.
Right.
We got to see the picture before we can jump in this thing. It's not about jumping in and saying, let's do something. Let's do this right here or revert with this right here. But you got to understand what you're going into. It's chess, not checkers.
Right.
At all times. You got to understand everything. So that's what we mess up a lot of times. We run into something, trying to change something, but ain't nobody sat down and talk about nothing.
Right.
You got to have a plan of action. You got to do it, man. And the positive side of Shelby, man, everybody love it, man.
That's what we coming for.
Everybody love it, man. You from here, you love Shelby. I don't care how long you gone. I bet you miss something about Shelby. Come here, you be like, man, time to go. It'll be a couple days, but we love Shelby, you know what I'm saying?
Right on.
Another instance, I'm gonna go back to when you said, you know, Smoketown. It ain't about the smoke. It ain't about what you putting in and taking out. It ain't about the inhale, exhale.
It's about the people
right here. About the people, everybody, every influence that comes here, you know, people that didn't live here, that teach here. About the people.
Tone AG, you know, standing in the front door of Broadview High School, man, I just had to come pay homage, man. I appreciate how
coming to this school and the people in this school helped me develop, man. It allowed me to go away from home and be able to conduct myself in a way where I could be away from home, not be out of state locked up or something, you know, maintain my freedom, put out the proper respect that I learned from these people. I want to call some names, but I really want to wait till I get to take my time and put a list of names together. And I really want to do a video tribute. But a lot of these teachers off top, man, Mr. Harris, I want to go down the long list. But, you know, like I said, Coach Peterson, Coach Washington, man, a lot of people, man, they did work outside of their job description for what I'm getting. Them people were about us, and they were about making sure that we came up the way we were supposed to come up. That's what we really getting at, man. The order and structure in the community is kind of slipping away from us. You know, the way that, and I know I'm young, you know, and being E young, but a lot of people, they got raised up, man. There was some real home training out right here in this town. There was some real teaching, some real, you know, some real people that really raising children up to be how they're supposed to be, man. And a lot of people have all gotten all the way away from that. You know, people ain't raising their children like that anymore. So, you know, I'm not pointing no fingers. I don't want nobody to get in their feelings about it. But just make it your business. Make sure you raise your child better than you raise them. Teach them about what used to happen back in the day. Don't let them get so disconnected from the history of their family and the history of their town or whatever. You know, I teach them about that. Raise your children better than you was raised. And watch what come out of them. Salute to all them teachers, man, that got at us and helped us outside of their job description, which means that we're not getting paid for that. So, salute to them again, man. Tony HD, E-Red, Smoketown, USA. Ain't nothing like shit, man. Ain't nothing like it. I love it.
The conflict's big, crucial. You tryna spit this proof and unusual. I'm choosing one to your suckers. Catch it as we hit us. The village lounge never picked it out. This place sold out.
Big wheel one more time. There you go.
All right.
All right.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Come on. Now if you want to shout, you got to play by the rules.
By the rules.
You got to do what I do. What I do, what I do. If you want to shout, you got to play by the rules. You got to do what I do. When I do, what I do.
Now,
step to the left,
step to the right,
it's in the round.
He had purchased this property here, and really they found him so dead over here on this property.
Found who dead right here? Over here on this property?
Yeah, one of the guys that Emmett Till.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
oh yeah, we ain't gotta go into it. They know about it. I just wanted to get the footage because we sitting here talking about that rich history, yeah. And Shelby. You know, like I said, people speak about the negative things. You know, they forgot about the good. Yeah. But
it's not only just what's happening.
It's happening. It's happening everywhere, right?
Because we can make Shelby a negative thing, but you know. Really, everywhere you go, man, because I went all over the country just about.
Right.
And I've seen some things that make me want to cry, you know.
Right.
I was traveling in the 60s and the 70s. I've seen Detroit and all those places.
Yeah, how rough it is. Right. Right, right. Yeah, it's rough, man. Everything kind of dying off, man, but, you know, it's up. It's happening everywhere, you know, and that's why I say it's up to the people, man. The people got to make things happen.
That's true.
The people got to make something happen.
And I always say, don't look for the government to do it.
Nah, don't look for no leaders. If you know what needs to happen, get together and make it happen. You know what I'm saying? It is what, especially if you ain't willing to do nothing, you should have nothing to say. Right.
Right. So we stood up there, and our parents told us, hey. You guys, y'all don't go up there, man. Y'all don't hurt anything. You don't do something to y'all, but if you, you know, we gonna watch that.
Right.
Somebody gonna kill me up there in
Missouri,
you know? And we had to go out there and let them go up there.
Right.
They had the boycott. They had the big football players stand out in front of those stores, in the doorway of the stores. Yeah. By the guy in the car, they stepped in front of the door like this here. Mm-hmm. Where you going? Said, I'm gonna go shopping, go buy some groceries. You want some groceries? They got a grocery store right down in Mountain Valley. Well, I can't go there, I ain't got no way, got no gas. There's a car right there, they'll take it. And they got them in the cars and drove to Mountain Valley to shop at the black store.
Oh, yeah.
That's when the boycott was going on. That's how it went.
Right.
You remember when the National Guard came in and had us on lockdown for so many days that, man, we felt like we were just in a
conversation
camp right here in jail.
Right. They finna talk.
The CLC, Southern Christian Leadership Conference, they came here with two child bosses. Took all the youth out of town. Mm-hmm. For a couple of days, so we was under that much pressure.
Right.
So people don't even know that.
What year was that, man?
That was in 1967, 66, somewhere in those
years. 3-4 years after they killed Kennedy.
Yeah, a couple years after they killed Kennedy. So Andrew Young, Avon, after all those guys came to jail.
Right. Who that came? Okay. See, this is what these youngsters need to know about the history of their town, man. You know, and not just the town, but, you know, you got to start at home. You got to start at home, man. Because like I said, I seen some stuff about Mountain Bayou that I didn't know that. I didn't know
about the all black town?
Yeah, I've been knowing that since my whole life, but I didn't know how they did it, how they back in the 1800s and stuff. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They were like, they ain't let white folk come down here with all that, man. And they took care of the house, man. I'm talking about how they got together, and because we can govern ourselves the right way. We don't need nobody to stand over us.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? So that's what I'm getting at. We gotta get these kids young, man. And turn them and make sure they turn out to be somebody who can, you know, act right without somebody having to come in and stand over and point a gun at them or something like that. You know what I'm saying?
That's a good point. And so that's being motivated
from within right now, we don't really understand and we don't have to go that route.
Right.
So it's good to hear somebody younger than right. me talking about that.
Right, right. We gotta behave ourselves.
Right.
And take care of each other and everything else gonna take care of itself, man.
Talent wise, we dominate in anything that we do.
Right.
These sports, you right. name it. We have the talent.
Right, right. And scholastics too. Because you know we you know, so we just got to highlight the history where the great things have happened that, you know, people forget about unless somebody, you know, like us come through and, you know, it'd be a reminder. I heard that. But what was you saying about the history before sagging?
Before the sagging, well, the sagging that people talk about today is what started in the jailhouse with people with their pants down.
Right.
That's what everybody today is talking about. Right. The people. But you go to the older people, they will give you some history. Some of the older people give you history that started in slavery.
Right.
The pants sagging wasn't just a choice that they made as a person. Right. It was shackles that people had wore on their pants legs.
Right.
On down below their pants on their feet so they couldn't run away.
Right.
So the next move they did, they took the shackles off so they can work freely when they're standing around working. Then they took and gave them big pants
right.
so they couldn't run away.
Right.
You can't run with your pants falling.
You gotta down. Hold them.
You gotta hold them up. So when right. you run, you gotta swing your arms.
You got to.
And so that's how that went. So before it became a slavery issue, I mean a jailhouse issue.
Right.
It was a way to keep the slaves from running.
Wow.
That's where it went first. And then it went from there to the jailhouse.
These youngsters gotta know that, man. Yeah. I have a lot of insight, but I did not know that.
A lot of people, you know, you see these videos and you see us in abandoned buildings and if you see. Like what's going on in the town, and you think, oh, it's a ghost town, ain't done this shit. This absolutely true. I never denied it. But you want to hear something funny? Shelby was once the Cleveland of the Mississippi Delta.
That's what I heard too.
You see, a lot of people don't know, but there's two words that mess this whole thing up. It's called highway.
Highway.
Man, Highway 61. I'm a Mississippi boy to the day I die, man.
398 search
team. Highway 61, man, used to run through here, and we had thriving businesses, man. He showed you on the backyard Mississippi, the Shelby Dockhead when you first come in. Any car park that you had before 94, 95 came from Shelby Dockhead, man. Right here in Shelby, Mississippi. This whole highway system
was some history, bro.
Full of business, man.
They ain't got no history.
Aria Aaron.
Right.
A Jewish owned store right here in Shelby, Mississippi. We didn't have to go to Cleveland. We didn't have to go to South Haven or Memphis to buy our clothes. We
right.
were fresh to death and you want nobody to go wear the same thing.
Right.
We were fresh to death. We had Larry's right here, right next
right.
to us, man.
You're
I'm
right,
old.
Man.
I'm 35 years old.
You're right.
So happy to say that because I'm still here and blessed and living. But we had so much going on in this town, man. Grocery stores with fresh food, fresh produce all the time. But we don't have that anymore. You know why we don't have it anymore?
Highway.
They put the highway man, whoever the business was, money deal, it is what it is. But they didn't look at the economic downfall it was gonna have towards this town.
Right.
See, everything that you had to pass through Shelby, Mississippi to get to Memphis and to get to Chicago and all the rest of these
right,
big towns.
Right.
Because well, Highway 61 was the one that was driving, man.
Out of sight, out of mind.
Out of sight, out of mind. That's the perfect way to put it, man.
Right.
The highway had to go around the town, and everything that go around the town don't come through the town, so you don't have to stop.
Somebody told me that this last time I heard you, the same thing, but you doing a little bit more detailing with it. It's,
yes.
You own it, man. You on point.
And had that highway stayed the same, man, there's no limit to the building that could be right here in the town.
Right.
You think about it. They're in Cleveland, Mississippi. Everybody's still going through Cleveland. Cleveland's never going to die
right.
because Highway 61 is still going through there.
Right.
A small town like Shelby that was thriving at the time, got a highway going around it now. Nobody comes through here.
Right.
You see a sign, and unless you on E, you ain't going to come to this town to get no gas.
Right.
You'll keep it moving.
Right.
All I'm saying is that don't get it twisted, man. So when you get a chance to come back to Shelby, Mississippi, spend your dollars in Shelby. We may not have much, but go ahead and give us something to, you know, work with.
Right.
You know, and I say us. I'm going to always say us. I live in Houston, Texas. It is what it is. I'm going to always say us. I just got there.
But this is home.
This is home. If you don't take care of home, what else you going to take care of?
Smoketown, where you from? Smoketown, where you from? You like some badass dope, man. Where you from?
where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from? Where you from? From that dirty south, the same one you heard about. Down here they still get served in the drought. Say where you from? 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 They call it Smoketown in daytime, ghost town at nighttime. It goes down, you know how that sounds. Say where you from?
Smoketown, man, y'all already know that. Town full of G's, but we family before that. Only keep off blowing loud, that's a throwback. When I was coming up, that's where everybody smoking. Ride down, run back to back, in them Chevys. Money, car, low.